Hello students, this is Purushottam Ingale welcoming you in the world of biology. In our previous videos, we have learned about basics of pollination, advantages of self-pollination. In this video, we'll learn advantages and disadvantages of cross-pollination. Basically, cross-pollination is the transfer of pollen grain from anther to stigma, which belongs to two different flowers present on two different plants. Those two different plants may have different gene combinations, and those genes can mix with each other during reproduction and can have different combinations of a gene, and the creation of new combination of genes is called as recombination, which is the biggest advantage of cross-pollination. Now, cross-pollination have advantages. The biggest one is recombination. In this, we have improved variety because we have various combinations of characters. The the combinations which favors the plant will be retained by the plant, and which are harmful for the plant, which will be left by the plant. So due to cross pollination, we can have hybrid vigor. Now, hybrid vigor is a tendency shown by offspring produced after the hybridization. In this, the offsprings become superior than the parent. The phenomenon is called as heterosis. And it's all is possible due to the cross-pollination. But with all these events, the cross-pollination favors evolution. And that's why, as cross-pollination favors evolution, nature favors cross-pollination. But the success doesn't come without spending energy. There are some disadvantages of cross-pollination, which are largely concerned with the wastage of energy. So in first, as cross-pollination involves two parents having different genetic combinations, you don't have surety of maintaining an improved character. So, there is no genetic purity in case of cross-pollination. Second, as external agencies involved, if biotic agents are involved, you need to spend energy for attracting them by making flowers large, by producing sand, by producing nectar, so that those agents will get attracted, and that needs energy. So cross-pollination is not economical. Now, as it is dependent on external agent, we have more chances of failure. And as it is dependent on external agent, you need to have production of large number of pollen grains so that at least one will get suitable stigma and will form seed. This is all about advantage and disadvantage of cross-pollination. I hope you understood this. If you have any queries, you can ask me on my email, which is puruingle5@gmail.com. Thank you.